So I thought, well, why don't I get two other people in to help? And Patton was already here, so I asked the lovely and talented Zelda Williams to come up and become part of this madness. So it's going to be a big help.
This looks like Walter Mambell's face. It's not good.
massages his white shoulders with her brown fingers. Then she turns him over and begins to make love to him with her hands and her fingers and her tongue. It seems to him that the lights in the red room have been dimmed, and the sole illumination comes from the candle, which burns with a bright flame.
What's your name?
He asks her.
Bilquis,
she tells him, raising her head.
With Q.
A what?
Never mind.
He's gasping now.
Let me fuck you, he says. I have to fuck you.
Okay, honey,
she says.
We'll do it, but will you do something for me while you're doing it?
Hey,
he says, suddenly tetching.
I'm paying you, you know.
She straddles him in one smooth movement, whispering.
I know, honey, I know. You're paying me. And I mean, look at you. I should be paying you. I'm so lucky.
He purses his lips, trying to show that her hooker talk is having no effect on him. He can't be taken, but she's a street whore, for Christ's sake. Well, he's practically a producer, and he knows all about and he knows all about last-minute rip-offs. But she doesn't ask for money. Instead, she says,
honey, while you're giving it to me, while you're pushing that big hard thing inside of me, will you worship me?
Will I what?
She's rocking back and forth on him. The engorged head of his penis is being rubbed against the wet lips of her vulva.
Will you call me goddess? Will you pray to me? Will you worship me with your body?
He smiles. Is that what she wants?
Sure,
he says. We've all got our kinks at the end of the day. She reaches her hand between her legs and slips him inside her.
Is that good? Is it, goddess?
He asks, gasping.
Worship me, honey.
Says Elvis, the hooker.
Yes,
he says.
I worship your breasts and your eyes and your I worship your thighs and your eyes and your cherry red lips.
Yes.
She croons, riding him like a storm-tossed boat rides the waves.
I worship your nipples, from which the milk of life flows. Your kiss is honey, and your touch scorches like fire, and I worship it.
His words are becoming more rhythmic now, keeping pace with the thrust and roll of the boys.
Bring me your nuts in the morning, and bring me your sleep and your blessing in the evening. Let me walk in the dark. Places are hard, then let me come to you. What more testing for that you would make love with you? And I worship you.
But her forefinger touches his chin and pushes his head back, so he's looking only at her face and at the ceiling once again.
Keep talking, honey.
She says.
Don't stop. Doesn't it feel good?
It feels better than anything I've ever felt.
He tells her, as he says it.
Your eyes are stars. Burning in the firmament, and your hips are gentle fiddling, but then and I worship them.
And now he's thrusting deeper and deeper inside her. It feels electric, as if his whole body has become sexually charged, triathlon, engorged, blissful.
Bring me your gift,
he mutters, no longer knowing what he's saying.
Your what? True gift, and make me always this. Always, so I pray, I...
And then the pleasure crests into orgasm, blasting his mind into dark. His head, himself, an entire beingness, a perfect one. As he thrusts deeper into her and deeper still, eyes closing, spasming, he luxuriates in the moment. And then he feels a lurch, And it seems to him that he's hanging, head down, although the pleasure continues. He opens his eyes. He thinks, grasping for thought and reason again at birth, and wonders without fear in a moment of perfect post-coital clarity whether what he sees is some kind of illusion. This is what he sees. He is inside her to the chest. And as he stares, in disbelief and wonder, she rests both hands upon his shoulders and puts gentle pressure on his forehead. He slips slides further inside her.
How are you doing this to me?
He asks. Or he thinks he asks. But perhaps it's only in his head.
You're doing it, honey.
She whispers. He feels the lips of her vulva tight around his upper chest and back, constricting and back. He wonders what this would look like to somebody watching them. He wonders why he's not scared. And then he knows.
I worship you with my body.
He whispers. As she pushes him inside her, her labia pulls swiftly across his face, and his eyes slip into darkness. She stretches on the bed like a huge cat, and then she yawns.
Yes,
she says.
You do.
The Nokia phone plays a high electrical transposition of the Ode to Joy. She picks it up and thumbs a key and puts the telephone to her ear. Her belly is flat, her labia small and closed. A sheen of sweat glistens on her forehead and on her upper lip.
Yeah.
She says. And then she says,
no, honey, he's not here. He's gone away.
She turns the telephone off before she pops out on the bed in the dark red room. And she stretches once more. And she closes her eyes. And she sleeps.
Very method, Neil. Sorry.
You know, I thought, you know, there is a pattern. Giving 1,500 people an experience they will not forget.
No, this will be a lot of therapy sessions tomorrow. I had a breakthrough last night I didn't want to have. Can we have 2 hours today, maybe?